Kodagu, situated in the eastern slopes of the Western Ghats, with a little more than 500,000 population, is one of the most famous hill stations of India and is variably known as the Kashmir of the South and sometimes as the Switzerland of India. Kodagu is a nature lover's paradise with great landscapes, lush green forests and misty valleys. The birthplace of the river Kaveri, the lifeline of Karnataka, is in Kodagu, known as Talakaveri, which is a famous pilgrimage center. Kodagu is a land of army generals, sportspersons, bureaucrats and men of quality.
In this land was born about 85 years ago our mentor Mr. P.K. Bhimaya, a quiet, soft-spoken man, modest in his demeanor but proud of his heritage. Surrounded by personalities imbibed with a spirit of patriotism and a desire to serve the country, our mentor is the very epitome of selfless service.
All through his life, he had a burning desire to serve his country. Like his role models Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Nehru and Field Marshal Karyappa, he believed that when you work with love serving your fellow men, you bind your true self to one another and to God. He felt that the best way to do so is in imparting education steeped in Indian culture and tradition with emphasis on strong character, right attitude and with sound moral and ethical values. As Gandhiji said, by education I mean all-round drawing out of the best in the child and man, body, mind and spirit. With this vision and with the blessings of Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa, he founded our school, the Daffodils English School, in 1978 amid 2 acres of beautiful flowering trees and landscape gardens in the heart of Sanjaynagar.
A journey of 1,000 leagues starts with a single step. Our mentor and his family built the school stage by stage, brick by brick. From modest beginnings, the school is now housed in one of the finest and well-planned buildings in Sanjaynagar. The nursery section of the school was founded first. The primary school, middle school and the high school sections were added in stages. The building itself rose stage by stage. The school vision statement clearly states that we believe in imparting creative, meaningful and responsive education with vision, in pursuing excellence in all fields, aspects of education, in personal involvement of staff members for making every student an achiever.
Many well-wishers of the school, Sister Humbeline and Sister Irene from Stella Maris, government officials and others have lent support to the governing council during the formative years of the school. With the vision of the school in mind, our school has chosen well-trained teachers who have made it their personal mission to help the school realize the school's vision. The teachers have the necessary skills in the fields of organization, presentation, analysis, synthesis, assessment, management and evaluation. This has enabled them to develop neutral and warm environments for positive achievements in student learning. The teachers, staff and sub-staff together form the soul of the school.
Bearing in mind that the first few years are very crucial in a child's life, the nursery teachers follow a carefully planned and vibrant curriculum. The primary school teachers are a purposeful and caring community in which they give importance in developing the skills of the children placed under their care in the 3 R's: reading, writing and arithmetic. Subject teachers, teachers who are proficient in their subjects of specialization, are entrusted with the task of teaching the middle school and high school students.
The school has well-equipped physics, chemistry and biology labs, computer labs and a well-stocked library. The audio-visual room has a state-of-the-art craft projector and audio systems which provide audio-visual support for the teachers. The school library's book, reading room and reprography sections serve as the knowledge center of the school. The mentor has close touch with each and every student of the school, interacting with them in both the classrooms and in the playing fields. The mentor inspires the staff and students with his personal touch and encourages them to keep the motto, "Do well all you do." Science and social studies exhibitions are organized every year to foster scientific temperament and encourage students to take an avid interest in history, culture and geography of our country. The school has qualified art and craft teachers who help the children develop their skills in different mediums of art and craft. Training in art and craft helps bring out the creative talents of the students. The children are encouraged to display the skills they have developed in the annual art and craft exhibitions organized in the school.
Members from the National Association of the Blind enthralled our students with their variety entertainment programs. They also had lunch with us. They helped our children to realize that physical disability is not a disadvantage but serves as a motivation to strive hard and excel in fields where the physical disability is not a handicap but serves as a blessing in disguise. We have had various dignitaries, Field Marshal Kariyappa, Justice Bopanna, Commissioner of Police, government officials, distinguished alumni of our school and others visiting our school. They have nothing but praise for the way the school activities are carefully chosen and organized and the excellence that the children of our school have attained in both academic and co-curricular fields.
Our school appreciates that the co-curricular activities help to develop the all-round personality of students. They provide an environment wherein the students can develop a sense of competitive spirit, leadership and team spirit, and a platform to demonstrate their creative skills and talents. Our school has a bulbul flock, a cub pack and a guide company organized under the Bharat Scouts and Guides Association. Physical training is an integral part of the curriculum followed in our school, which helps in the physical development of the children. Karate, a form of martial arts, helps a person purge oneself of selfish and evil thoughts. Karate training is being imparted in our school since 2002.
The excursions organized by the school are meticulously planned and conducted. Life, it is said, is not about reaching a destination but about enjoying the journey. Coaching in cricket, football, hockey and basketball is provided to our students.
School sports are conducted annually. Our school band is well trained and actively participates in all our school field activities. The school is divided into four houses: Iris, Lily, Poppy and Tulip. Inter-house competitions are conducted to help achieve the objects of the co-curricular activities. We organize separate sports for nursery, middle and high school sections. At the end of the academic year, we have the graduation ceremony where we bid goodbye to our Standard 10 students. This is a very emotional ceremony.
Students who graduate from our school then join the alumni association. During the association's get-together, they get an opportunity to renew their relations with the school and to strengthen their bonds with the school. As the daffodils that have bloomed leave the portals of our school, new daffodils sprout.